Greetings everyone and welcome back to Minecraft. In the previous episode we took a look at that office building over there and also had a quick brief look at this little train station slash pub here. So if you want to check those out in a bit more detail, you can check that video out now. But today, this is actually going to be the final video. We're going to wrap this whole map up because this is getting to the end now. Because all there is a bridge and a couple of buildings out the other side of this bridge, and that is it. So let's actually just take a look at the road. Let's just take this all in as the ambience of this wee little town here with our fire station, our police station, our road, our sort of apartment block thing here. We have all of the road markings here. We have a road sign, blue road sign, which means this must be a motorway sign, because I think blue signs mean motorway signs in England. And I don't actually know what side of the road. This looks like with this line here that it should actually be made for left-hand drive, but that design over there pretty much says that that is for right-hand drive, so that is a bit confusing. That seems to have switched around what that should be. Right, here is the bridge before we go any further. So the bridge is made with these panels here like that. So we've got one panel there and one panel there. That's all inside of one block, I think. Let's just grab some grass so we can have a look. Is that all inside? There we go. All inside of one block. And all I did there, because as you can see, if you place that down, then place it again, it's just going to make it bigger. I place it down, hold shift, then click, and that will build it at the top of the same block. So that's all he's done here. So he's built that up, and then in between every other one, he's put in a pillar in the middle, and that's how he's got that border design. And then he's got these really cool little light things, black metal platforms with some inverted light gray lanterns on the top, attached to an infernal block pillar, and then we just have the same sort of design here, but using hollow sandy brick panel to get that sort of thing. And as you can see, that's built up from the block as well, so that they stick out a wee bit more than the rest of them. And hello, sheep. So if we get down here, let's just have a look at the outside of this bridge. We have this sort of quartz thing going around here as some sort of like strip design that goes around there. And then we have a little bit that goes on every other block across here. We also have these lines going down at these points, as you can see, with the lampposts like that, that, that. And then that brings us this bridge here. Very interesting design underneath. He has used a huge amount of micro blocks here, as you can see. There is the full block. There's the full block. There's the full block. And as you can see, it's gradually getting bigger. Panel. These are all panels. That's slab. So that would be a slab there, slab there. Then these would be panels that are built up 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. Then that would be 1, 2, 3. That's actually a single block there again. So it goes block. Let's just have a look at this. Block. Then slab, then pillars that are made to be slightly longer than slab, then block again. And he's gone all the way up and repeated that up until here. We've also got this nice little circle bit here. And that's how he's made the big, smooth, lovely looking arches for this bridge. Let's just get rid of that, get rid of that, build that back in. There we go. And he's got some lights underneath this bridge, so this whole thing will be lit up, because otherwise it would be really dark under here. And he's also got these going around here. Just these quartz strips going around here like that. Looks pretty cool. Looks really cool indeed. And it goes all the way along like that, until we get to the end. And we actually have a massive hole going through here. Yeah, this mod pack is just, it's dead. This mod pack is dead. But we can actually see where he's underneath lit up that bit that he's filled in there with the bridge. But let's actually take these buildings out for the last bit of the video. Before we do, look at this. He's actually got a mini roundabout in this thing. He's built that up using mostly blocks with the occasional little thing there. Let's just grab these so I can show you how to make those. It's very easy to make. Like that, and then like that. But they would all be done in the same block. Let's actually do, there we go. All like that in the same block, like that. Very very easy to do, as you can see there. Very simple indeed. And that's how he's made this little mini roundabout going around here. And as you can see, I think that he was definitely going for left-hand drive, so I think he may have just messed up inside of the fire station design back there. Left-hand drive, going around there, around this way, around the roundabout, out to here, until these little shops here at the end. I don't know whether this was the latest thing he built or the first thing he built. I don't know which way around this map was built, but have a go and have a look at this. Right, so this is the little thing here. This is the, what's it called again? It's not a post box. It's a phone box. That's the one. Nice British phone box. It's a little bit big, but it works. It works fine. So this is our first building. This looks very cool indeed. So this is made with sandy brick and quartz. Quartz is sort of broken up the bottom bit here. So we have the doors that are surrounded by the brick there, there, and there. And then he's filled the rest in with quartz. And then he's used brick on top. And he's used very cool things. He's used quartz on the corners as well. And he's offset them so they don't actually match. So when we look at that, he's not building them around so they go like that and up. He's built them so they go like that and up, which is very cool indeed. So we have like that, and that's how he's done the corners there. Very simple. Again, microblocks is really not that difficult. It's mostly just having to think, not in technicals of, you know, you don't have to think of just giant blocks in Minecraft. You're thinking on a slightly smaller scale, but they're not too hard. So I don't think you guys should have any trouble actually breaking into microblocks and building it. It'd probably take maybe a few hours and you'd probably get the hang of it, to be quite honest with you. Not that big of a learning curve with microblocks, as big as you may as expect. Moving along here, we've got these nice little bits here that are broken up every other block with a slightly thicker thing. And then on top, these are mostly just stairs, aren't they? Yep, they're just standard stairs, even on the corners, just standard stairs. Like that, of course, but it's not going to work because we've already got some in that's actually broken that up. And then we have these nice, simple chimneys here. Very simple. And he's also used red on the bottom of that, just some red wall strip on the bottom. And I like that. I like that he's used colors around some of the edges on some of these windows, because without them, they would probably look a little bit boring. We also have red on these ones too. And interestingly, he's used different colored bricks for the two different terraces here, as well as them having the same thing here. Now, there's no sort of wall in between, so I imagine that even though there's two doors, this is meant to be the same building. So what this is essentially like the joining of two terraces with a shop underneath. So this would be like a little boutique or a hairdresser's or something like that. There's smoke for some very strange reason. Where's that coming from? Where was that? Oh, okay. I think it's because the block that he's used with this carpenter's doors would emit a particle, and because he's used it on the carpenter's doors, the particle still emits. I didn't know that would happen. That's pretty cool. I don't know what block that is. I think that might be something called ash. Let's look for that. Ash block, biomes are plenty. If we place this outside, let's just have a look. Is this going to emit some sort of particle? There we go. So that's it then. So all we have to do is just build that up there, put our door in, put our ash block in. Of course, now it's emitting particles. That is really cool. And I don't know if he intended for the particles to be there and perhaps has wanted to use the black texture, but he's inadvertently discovered that we can have particles coming out of carpenter's blocks. Very interesting indeed. So we have an upstairs area, again, pretty much empty. But as you can see, this must definitely be two terraces that have been joined together as one. But you still get the clue that they were two different terraces by the fact they had different colours and separate chimneys. But that's something you would actually commonly see in England, and that is like joining of these for shops or something like that. And then we have these two on the end. These are like little houses, terrace houses again. You would have terrace houses next to shops in a little village or something like that. That's perfectly fine. And as you can see, we have our stairs going up to the top bit with our little banisters made out of white metal platforms. And then again, next door, we should have the exact same thing here. We also have blue window frames as well. Very interesting for that one. But of course, it's because in England, people can, you know, people often paint the front of their houses. They paint the window frames different colors. So we do get to see different colors and stuff, even if they do look really weird when they're sort of transferred into Minecraft. But never mind. Oh, that was meant to be me opening the door. Right, so there we go. There's that. Going upstairs. Pretty simple, exactly the same as the last one. And this pretty much concludes everything inside of this map. Here is a little street lamp that goes basalt on the bottom, like that. And then we have white metal platforms, like that. These are all red, not red power, these are all railcraft blocks, like that, like that. And then he's used the platforms, which has completed the thing. As you can see, these change depending on what's connected next to them, so they would actually connect. Like that. Very cool. Very simple design. Very nice. I like that. So there we go, guys. That is it. That is every Sachin build finished. We will no longer be looking at these builds. There we go, guys. That is it for this video and all of these videos. And maybe that's it for me doing build showcases. Unless you guys actually submit something else that you've built. Because I don't think I'm going to be continuing with my Let's Build series and my Let's Build project. Because that's just, it's a project that I've lost a lot of interest in through all the problems that we've had over time with the mod pack not working, being screwed around, all that sort of stuff. And I've just sort of lost interest in the whole project. So sorry, guys, for those of you that would perhaps want me to do loads of Let's Build stuff, but it's really just not me anymore. I need to move on, and this is just how I'm moving on. So there we go, guys. That is it. Thank you very much for watching, and I will see you all next time. Goodbye.